going to perform an experiment in which I have a small bar magnet here, and this bar magnet is already marked with north and south, and I'm going to plot the magnetic field lines around it, and then I'm going to teach you how to find out the null points or neutral points in the magnetic field. So before starting the experiment, just look at the theory first, and then we will begin the experiment. So here I have a model of the earth, figure of the earth, and a line passing through the north and south is called geographic axis. And this geographic axis, this point on the earth is called geographic north, and this point on the earth is called geographic south. Now, we know that the center of the earth, which is called the core is actually made up of the molten metals like iron, chromium, nickel. There are many metals which are there in the core part, and basically the main part is the iron. And we know that iron is magnetic in nature. And now what happens is this molten liquid, which is filled inside the core, it is like rotating inside. It is in a state of motion. So due to that, the current is generated, electric currents are generated, and that electric current is responsible for the magnetism of the earth. So that's why we can say that the earth behaves as a huge magnet. Now the wonderful thing to observe is that, suppose if I consider earth as a huge magnet, then the north pole of the magnet of the earth is in the Antarctica, and the south pole is at the Canada. So we call this Canada as magnetic south, and we call Antarctica as magnetic north, as the north pole of the huge bar magnet is actually on the Antarctica. Now actually, if you try to dig on the earth, and you will never be able to get the magnet. This is just a model that we are looking at. So you have to consider that the earth has, inside the earth there is a very big huge magnet that is buried, and its north pole is in the Antarctica and south pole is on the Canada. But practically, if you try to dig it, you will not get anything, right? Fine. Now what else do we need to study? We need to understand one more thing, that this is the earth's magnet and this is my bar magnet, correct? Okay, now if I put my bar magnet like this, like north towards the north of the earth's magnet, then these two poles are going to repel, and these two poles are also going to repel, south and south. So my bar magnet is going to turn like this, and it is going to face such that the magnetic south and my magnetic north of my bar magnet are facing towards each other. So that's what I'm going to do over here. I have a very small bar magnet, sorry, a compass, and this compass I'm going to put it like this. Now you can see that this reddish part, which is shown over here, this magnetic compass is made up of magnetic needle, and its red color part over here is again north pole. That means, since this north pole of the bar magnet should face south pole of the earth's magnet, that means I can say that in this direction we have earth's magnetic south, correct? Okay, and this is the south pole of the compass, which is facing towards the earth's pole's magnetic north. Now people, what am I going to do is, since we know that this is the north pole of the bar magnet of the earth, now I am going to put this bar magnet such that its north pole is facing the north pole of the earth's magnet, and I am going to put it exactly on this line, correct? Now what is going to happen is, this north pole of the magnet of the earth, this is the earth's magnetic south pole. So the magnetic field lines will come from north, they will go to the south. Now its magnetic field lines will originate from north and they will go towards the south. So that means from the north pole, the magnetic field lines are coming down of the earth, and the north pole of the bar magnet will send the magnetic field lines in the upward direction. So there will be a point where the magnetic field of both will be equal and opposite, and that point is called the neutral point, and as you can see it is on the axial line. Now here, again the magnetic field lines of the Earth's North Pole are going to go like this, and the magnetic field lines of this bar magnet will come like this. So again there is another point where the magnetic field lines, where the magnetic field of the Earth and the bar magnet are equal. So I'm getting basically two neutral points. As you can see that these two are the magnetic field lines of the Earth's magnet, and these two are the magnetic field lines of my bar magnet. So there are two points where exactly the field is equal and opposite. And how do we know that whether I have reached at the neutral point or not? So I'm going to take a compass like this. I'm going to put it exactly on the axis. Now here this is showing the deflection because it is very near to this bar magnet. Now as I start moving this in the backward direction, still this is in the vicinity of this bar magnet, so it is going to always point towards this bar magnet. But suppose if I keep on pushing it in the backward direction, a point will come where it is going to deflect exactly like this. So this is the point where both the magnetic fields are equal. So that means this point is a neutral point. Now let's move on to the practical part, people. So now let's begin the practical. What I have done is exactly at the center of the page, I have kept a compass, and the compass always shows north and south direction. So first of all, let me mark these two, these points, north and south, like this. Now I'm going to join these two points like this. Let me mark this with a marker. These were the two points. Now we know that this direction, people, as you can see, this direction is north and this direction is south, right? Okay, now I'm supposed to put the bar magnet like this, its north pole pointing the north pole of the magnet of the Earth. So that means, as discussed earlier, that this is the geographic south. That means it is the magnetic north. So that means I am on a line where the magnetic field of the Earth and the magnetic field of our bar magnet are going to repel each other. So now I'm going to outline our magnet like this one. I'll make sure during the entire experiment that the magnet doesn't move, but even if it does move by a little, then we don't have to worry about, because we have already done the outline, so we can place back the magnet. Okay, people, you see that? Now this is the north and this is the south of our magnet, like this. I'm going to put it back. Now again I'm going to place the needle like this, this compass needle, and very quickly I'm supposed to mark two points, one above and one below our magnetic compass, where the needle is pointing like this, in this way. I'm supposed to make sure that the magnetic needle doesn't move too much, and I would recommend that you do this experiment very patiently, otherwise there are chances of mistakes over here. As you can see that now the magnetic needle has stopped the deflection, so I'm going to continue with the experiment again like this. this is one field line above the magnet. Now let me make another one like this and this. Like this one, people. So now I have one set of the magnetic field lines which are ready. So I'm going to join them like this. Magnetic field lines, they always originate from north and they go towards the south pole like this. In this way, people, I am supposed to draw a few more lines. Now is our most important task, people, that I'm going to put this bar magnet back again over here. Let me check whether this is the north and south. Yes, I'm correct only. So I'm going to put this compass over here. Now slowly and steadily, I'm going to take this compass in the backward direction and I'm going to look for a point where it shows deflection. Like this one. See, people, this is the point where this needle can rest in any positions because both the magnetic fields are equal and opposite over here. So let me encircle this compass over here, and this is our first neutral point. Let's call this as N1. Now again, I'm going to move this in this direction like this, and if it shows deflection, it is not showing right now any deflection because it is in the field of this, but somewhere over here it is resting in any position because here the magnetic field of the earth and the magnetic field of the bar magnet, they cancel each other out. So that means the magnetic needle can rest in any position. Let me call this as neutral point number 2. Right, people? So hopefully you have understood this entire experiment. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel, and if you have any